Welcome to the East Coast College Lowestoft campus. The first area we will explore is our Learning Resource Center. Along the right-hand side is a series of glass pods with green seating where you can meet and talk to our student services team. Up the stairs, you will find more seating and rows of books and documents to help you with your studies. From here, you can see the mezzanine area above the pods where we have computer space. Back down the stairs and through the Learning Resource Center, we can head to our student canteen. Our student canteen is a large, colorful room filled with tables and chairs, providing hot and cold food, snacks and drinks from two main counters at the front as well as vending machines. Out the door and up the stairs, you arrive in our tower building. Straight ahead through the double doors is a staircase that leads up to all five floors where a lot of our classrooms are based. A lift to access each floor is also available. As we move through the doors on level 1, you will find our maths and English classrooms. The first door on the left is a maths classroom, set out with tables and chairs and computers down one side. Back out of the classroom and down the stairs, we can travel to our East restaurant and training kitchens. We are now entering East Restaurant. The restaurant is run by our hospitality and catering students where they welcome in members of the public to practice their cooking, serving and front of house skills. The restaurant has its own bar area with leather seating and plenty of tables and chairs for diners. Around the back of the restaurant and up the stairs is where our training kitchens are located. Our kitchens have areas to prepare, cook and serve and replicate the kitchens you will work in once you move into the industry. A second training kitchen can be found in the back room with the same setup. If you travel back through the restaurant and into the corridor, you will be back in the tower building. On the right through the glass doors, we have our student support team who can answer any questions you may have during your time at college. Straight ahead and up the stairs, you will find a long corridor with office space on each side. At the very end on your right, you will find our foundation learning area. As you pass through the colorful locker area, you will come to our foundation classrooms. Our first classroom is a bright and colorful room with desk space, computers to work on, and beanbags for relaxing. Through the far door you will find another learning space. Inside we have further computer space, a large working area and lots of creative space. We have now arrived at the East Coast Health and Fitness Center, which is in a separate building outside the back of the college. Here we run our sports and physical activity courses. The gym area is fully equipped with cross trainers, exercise bikes, treadmill, weight machines and more. Outside the room the corridor leads down to a stairway and lift where you can access the sports classrooms. On the first floor you can move down to the sports classrooms, which are named after sporting heroes. On the right is the Serene Williams Suite, a classroom filled with tables and chairs, decorated with sports and health related information and posters. We have now moved into our automotive workshop. The workshop includes a full MOT test lane and modern diagnostic equipment, and students get the chance to practice their skills on the college's fleet of cars. To the left there is further workshop space with more engines and motors to work on. Our next space to explore is the Horizon Building, where we have our hair and beauty salons and travel and tourism classroom. At the back is the reception desk for Images Salon, which is run by our hairdressing and beauty students. Straight ahead is our first beauty room, a large space with treatment beds and makeup areas for students to learn their skills, as well as desk space in the center for theory lessons. To the left is the main hair salon. This large mirrored room is filled with hair stations for washing, cutting, coloring and styling. Up the stairs is where our travel and tourism and air cabin crew students are taught. The travel and tourism classroom includes a mock-up aircraft cabin, which is unique to the area and allows students to experience what it would be like working in an aeroplane. The rest of the room is filled with desk and computer space, maps of the world and travel brochures. On the same level we have a large computer area for lessons. We have now moved to the Sir Christopher Cockerell Building, where our construction and engineering courses are based. On the right we have our carpentry and joinery workshop. This large room is filled with wooden work benches where you will learn building methods and construction technology. Back out the door and straight ahead down the corridor you will find our brickwork workshop. This room is filled with blocks and bricks for students to learn how to build walls, arches, and masonry structures. If you continue down the corridor to the very end, you will find three more workshops. As you travel down the corridor, you will see British values displayed on the left wall and information about Sir Christopher Cockerell and his hovercraft invention on the right. The workshop on the right is for mechanical engineering. This room is split into areas with a classroom straight ahead through the double doors, bench space at the front and industry, standard equipment and machinery at the back. On the other side of the hallway is the welding workshop. This room is again filled with lots of machinery for practical work, including sheet metal practices, welding practices, and engineering drawing. Around the corner to the left is the metal fabrication workshop. This is another large workspace where students use a range of industry, standard equipment to learn the skills needed to go into employment. If we make our way out of the workshop, we can travel back down the corridor the way we came to move up to the first floor. A left turn here takes you to the stairwell. You can take the stairs or lifts up to more workshop and classroom space. We are now on the second floor landing. If you go through the double doors and turn right, you will first come to our painting and decorating workshop. As you walk through the workshop, you will pass individual work areas on both sides where students get the chance to practice their skills in brush and roller painting, papering walls and ceilings, and creating and applying color. The colorful walls and painted doors and windows make it feel like a little village. If you move back out of the workshop and into the corridor, you can turn right to see the final workshop in our Cockerell building. At the end of the corridor, the first door on the right is our electrical workshop. Inside, in the center of the room, you will find two large workbenches, and along the right-hand side are a series of individual work areas where students can practice their wiring and installation techniques. That concludes the tour of our Lowestoft campus. We hope you've enjoyed it.